The bottom line on nuclear weapons is that when the president gives the order, it must be followed. There's about 4 minutes between the order being given and the people responsible for launching nuclear weapons to do so.
As president, I will make it clear that the United States will treat cyber attacks just like any other attack. We will be ready with serious political, economic, and military responses.
They're voting for peace on planet Earth if they vote for Trump. But if they vote for Hillary, it's war.
People sometimes say that the Clintons are doing some good through the foundation and so on, but when you're collecting hundreds of millions of dollars, let's say to rebuild Haiti.
Utter devastation in Haiti.
And you give less than 10% directly to people in need.
Tens of thousands are feared dead after a 7.0 magnitude earthquake left much of the capital city of Port-au-Prince in ruins.
Haiti has this devastating earthquake in January of 2010. The world pays attention, sees the suffering, the money floods in. The Clintons, in a sense, hijack the government initiative.
The best thing they can do for the next week to 10 days is send cash, even if it's $5 or $10.
Send cash, even if it's $1 or $2. Send it to this website. I will give the cash to the people immediately. And that website is www.clintonfoundation.org/Haiti earthquake.
Please, if you can, contribute. $10 will be billed to your cell phone, and it's helping us get the food, the water, the medical supplies that we need.
Hundreds of millions of dollars in taxpayer money that flowed into Haiti that were supposed to rebuild roads, build homes, create infrastructure, create commercial opportunities. Those things didn't happen. The one thing that the Clintons did, build a textile factory, they didn't even build in the part of Haiti that was affected by the earthquake. And it was largely a factory for the benefit of a handful of Clinton Foundation donors who give to their political causes and who give to the Clinton Foundation. If you talk to Haitians in New York, a lot of them demonstrate outside the Clinton Foundation saying, where did the money go?
Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you!
We are telling the world of the crimes that Bill and Hillary Clinton are responsible for in Haiti. And we are telling the American people that the 32,000, over 32,000 emails that Hillary Clinton said she deleted have evidence of the crimes they've committed.
So I can only imagine if Hillary Clinton is president and this apparatus continues to hum along and expands, how bad it's truly going to be.
Now we know why Hillary ignored those emergency calls for help from Benghazi. She couldn't figure out how to make a buck off of them.
With all due respect, the fact is we had four dead Americans. Was it because of a protest, or was it because of guys out for a walk one night who decided they'd go kill some Americans? What difference at this point does it make?
Now we know why Hillary never gives up the con about storing secret emails on her private server.
And there were no security breaches.
When it comes to national security, what difference at this point does it make?
You're saying the Clinton server was unprotected?
No.
Yes.
And you had total access to it had you wanted to download it?
Yes.
Even after she's been busted.
Did you wipe the server?
What, like with a cloth or something?
Well, no.
Hillary denies. Now we know who Hillary Clinton really is. And we know the secret history of the Democratic Party.
Go down, Moses, way down in Egypt land.
First, in the period of slavery and segregation, the Democrats took everything from some.
Let my people go
Then progressivism through confiscatory taxation and regulation took something from everyone. If Hillary is elected president, we could see the completion of this thievery project in which the Hillary Democrats take everything from everyone. This would turn all of America into a plantation. Democrats are the party of exploitation, subjugation, and theft. They blame the South, or Republicans, or even America for the horrible things that they have done. They are the ones who are to blame. In addition to Indian removal and slavery, the Democrats are also the party of the Black Codes, segregation, Jim Crow, the Ku Klux Klan, lynching, forced sterilization, and sympathy for fascism. Democrats today claim to be the party of progress. But where's the progress? For blacks, they've created new urban plantations. For Indians, reservations. And for poor immigrants, barrios, ghettos, and slums. They put their voters in there and make sure they stay there. The only progress we see is progress for them. More wealth, more power, more control over America and over our lives. The Clintons are worthy successors of a tradition from Andrew Jackson through Woodrow Wilson. Are we not done with this larcenous duo? How much these partners in crime have already stolen from us? How much more will we let them take?
Some candidates in this race are resorting to ugly, hateful rhetoric.
Hateful rhetoric? The Clintons are hateful people with a hateful history. Imagine how much worse things could get if these two depraved crooks return to the White House.
Planet Earth if they vote for Trump, but if they vote for Hillary, it's war.
People sometimes say that the Clintons are doing some good through the foundation and so on, but when you're collecting hundreds of millions of dollars, let's say to rebuild Haiti.
Utter devastation in Haiti.
And you give less than 10% directly to people in need.
Tens of thousands are feared dead after a 7.0 magnitude earthquake left much of the capital city of Port-au-Prince in ruins.
Haiti has this devastating earthquake in January of 2010. The world pays attention, sees the suffering, the money floods in. The Clintons, in a sense, hijack the government initiative.
The best thing they can do for the next week to 10 days is send cash, even if it's $5 or $10.
Send cash, even if it's a dollar or $2. Send it to this website. I will give the cash to the people immediately. And that website is www.clintonfoundation.org/Haiti earthquake.
Please, if you can, contribute. $10 will be billed to your cell phone, and it's helping us.
The bottom line on nuclear weapons is that when the president gives the order, it must be followed. There's about 4 minutes between the order being given and the people responsible for launching nuclear weapons to do so.
As president, I will make it clear that the United States will treat cyber attacks just like any other attack. We will be ready with serious political, economic, and military responses.
They're voting for peace on planet.
Get the food, the water, the medical supplies that we need.
Hundreds of millions of dollars in taxpayer money that flowed into Haiti that were supposed to rebuild roads, build homes, create infrastructure, create commercial opportunities. Those things didn't happen. The one thing that the Clintons did, build a textile factory, they didn't even build in the part of Haiti that was affected by the earthquake. And it was largely a factory for the benefit of a handful of Clinton Foundation donors who give to their political causes and who give to the Clinton Foundation. If you talk to Haitians in New York, a lot of them demonstrate outside the Clinton Foundation saying, where did the money go?
Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you!
We are telling the world of the crimes that Bill and Hillary Clinton are responsible for in Haiti. And we are telling the American people that the 32,000, over 32,000 emails that Hillary Clinton said she deleted have evidence of the crimes they've committed.
So I can only imagine if Hillary Clinton is president and this apparatus continues to hum along and expands, how bad.
Way down in Egypt land.
First, in the period of slavery and segregation, the Democrats took everything from some.
Let my people go.
Then progressivism through confiscatory taxation and regulation took something from everyone. If Hillary is elected president, we could see the completion of this thievery project in which the Hillary Democrats take everything from everyone. This would turn all of America into a plantation. Democrats are the party of exploitation, subjugation, and theft. They blame the South, or Republicans, or even America for the horrible things that they have done. They are the ones who are to blame. In addition to Indian removal and slavery, the Democrats are also the party of the Black Codes, segregation, Jim Crow, the Ku Klux Klan, lynching, forced sterilization, and sympathy for fascism. Democrats today claim to be the party of fraud.
It's truly going to be.
Now we know why Hillary ignored those emergency calls for help from Benghazi. She couldn't figure out how to make a buck off of them.
With all due respect, the fact is we had four dead Americans. Was it because of a protest, or was it because of guys out for a walk one night who decided they'd go kill some Americans? What difference at this point does it make?
Now we know why Hillary never gives up the con about storing secret emails on her private server.
And there were no security breaches.
When it comes to national security, what difference at this point does it make?
You're saying the Clinton server was unprotected?
No.
Yes.
And you had total access to it had you wanted to download it?
Yes.
Even after she's been busted.
Did you wipe the server?
What, like with a cloth or something? Well, no.
Hillary denies. Now we know who Hillary Clinton really is. And we know the secret history of the Democratic Party.
Go down, Moses.